Melbourne, Australia's epicentre of coffee, culture, and as of this week, coronavirus. With the rainy city currently experiencing a COVID spike, there's just never been a better time to stay the f*** away. So if you can't go to Melbourne, why not bring Melbourne to you? As we all know, Melburnians love their coffee, even if they can no longer smell it. And you can still get that Melbourne feel at home by nominating a family member to act aloof while they make you a latte. Thanks, Troy. Even before the Rona, Melbourne was no stranger to unpredictable temperature swings. And to recreate that weather at home, I've opened that window, closed that door, the heating and cooling are both on, and I've left a kink in the front hose, so it will spray me with water when I least expect it. While Melbourne's laneways may look dirtier than a nasal swab, they're famous for their street art. At home, simply have your kid piss in a corner, then scribble cartoonish metaphors about capitalism on the wall. Is that a Banksy? Melbourne was always famous for its shopping and is making headlines again for its latest wave of panic buying. To experience this at home, simply swap out your toilet paper for lasagna sheets. And speaking of second waves, why not pretend you're at one of Melbourne's gorgeous beaches? It's easy with just a sprinkle of sand and smattering of band-aids. I've pre-swallowed the cigarette butts. Melbourne, it truly is the city that has it all, including, we should again stress, COVID-19. And in the Victorian Premier's own words.
Why would you want to go there?
Exactly.